as you can tell, it is very clearly too damn windy to do any spraying, but that's okay because I really want to finish up spreading. So, and also as you can probably see, when I get done down here today, I'm going to call my chemical guy and tell him that I need some respray because, actually, wait a minute. This was the first field I sprayed. And this was the first pad. Yep. Okay. I bet this was when the booms were cleaning out and they still just had water in them. I bet if I drive down there a little ways, it's all burnt. I know I'm gonna have to respray down here anyway, but this is as bad as I thought. I bet the booms are still full of water right here instead of having chemical in them. But anyhow. Got the same piece of shit spreader that I had the other day. I don't think that cord should be in there. And the difference is now it's a piece of shit spreader with a new leaf spring and not new, but air tire with air in it. Although, you think they could have found something better to throw on it than that bald motherfucker. But, oh well. I gotta spread out a ton and a quarter. That's all I gotta get out. I gotta get a ton and a quarter out of it. And then, not my problem. So, anyhow, let's get after it. Back to mom and dad's. I was gonna do the end of the video, but I had to stop real quick and get this on camera because this looks cool as hell. That cloud bank over there is looking like a mountain on the horizon. I thought that was a really cool picture. All right, so that job's done. That pretty much gets all the corn taken care of, except I am going to have to go down there and respray it because I got red, definitely got some baby ragweed showing up in the stuff that I had sprayed first. Not this, obviously, the stuff that I just got sprayed this last Saturday, whenever it was. Yep, Saturday morning. That stuff's still burning down, so, but we'll just respray the whole thing if it comes to that, because the nice thing about that Halex is it's got a free respray program, so I don't got to pay for it. If I don't got to pay for it, might as well do it. And since I have to respray it, it's looking kind of like I'm, well, what everybody that I've talked to has been telling me is I need to get some manganese on it. So if I'm going to go down there and respray it with Halex, I'm going to get some manganese mixed in with their, mixed into that program. I should have done it on the first round. But in hindsight, I'm glad I didn't, because then I would have had a full tank of manganese, or a full tank of corn mixed with manganese blended in. And I would have got blown off that field because of the wind, and I would have had nowhere else to spray it. I would have had to have waited for that field because it's got to go down there. Not that it's going to hurt spraying it on anything else. It's been a waste of money because nothing else around here has a manganese deficiency because it's all heavy ground. So, and hopefully tomorrow this wind will be died down and I can get spraying beans, because I really need to get to spraying beans. They're getting freaking ugly. But can't spray if it's too windy. And like today has been like nuts. There, we had a cool front, I guess you want to call it, blow through. We had a front blow through that dropped their temperature. It's actually pleasant outside. This weekend it was, we were like mid 90s. Now it's like upper 70s. It's perfect. It could stay like this all summer if it wanted to. But with that front came this low pressure system, and now we got all this wind. But it's supposed to calm down tomorrow afternoon, and Wednesday, Thursday are supposed to be good. So if Wednesday, even if I can't spray tomorrow, if Wednesday and Thursday are good, I can get all my beans sprayed in two afternoons. No problem. So should be done spraying beans, clean the sprayer out, switch it back to corn, get chemical coming. Probably not this coming weekend, the following weekend, or not this coming weekend, but the following week sometime. Get down there and get the corn sprayed again and get that manganese on it and help it out. So, and then once I get done spraying beans, all the corn's taken care of, get that second round of spraying done. What you doing, teeter pup? Get the second round of spraying done down there on the muck and get it taken care of, and we'll be done babysitting all the all the summer crops for the time being, and focus on, I need to get my grain truck put back together, which hopefully my last two radiator hoses show up tomorrow, because that turned into a goat rodeo that will be explained. That the whole radiator hose with that grain truck thing was a goat rodeo that will be explained in that grain truck video. And then I got my oil pressure gauge back, so we need to get that put back in the combine so I can get the 7300 over here. I got 8 bearings to change on it, and it'll be ready to go because I won't change the oil in it until this fall. I'll run wheat with it on this oil change. And then that'll probably take us right up to around the time to cut wheat. So that's the way things are looking. There'll be a couple other videos scattered in there. So anyway, yeah, guess that's it for this one. I'll catch you guys on the next one.